हमारे YouTube चैनल में आप सभी का स्वागत है। अगर अभी तक आपने हमारा YouTube चैनल सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो अभी सब्सक्राइब कर लीजिए, बेल आइकन बटन को प्रेस कर लीजिए ताकि समय-समय पर हमारे वीडियोस आपको मिलते रहें। सो इन एलजेब्रा ऑफ लिमिट्स इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव प्रूव्ड एन इम्पोर्टेंट रिजल्ट। लिमिट एक्स टेंड्स टू ए एफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू एल, लिमिट एक्स टेंड्स टू ए जी एक्स इक्वल टू एम, देन लिमिट एक्स टेंड्स टू ए एफ एक्स प्लस माइनस जी एक्स विल बी इक्वल टू एल प्लस माइनस एम। सो दिस रिजल्ट वी हैव प्रूव्ड इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर। टुडे we will continue algebra of limit and next result we are going to discuss. What is next result? If limit x tends to a fx equal to l fx equal to l and limit x tends to a gx equal to m, then limit x tends to a fx into gx fx into gx will be equal to l into m, l into m. So if limit of functions fx and gx are l and m respectively, then limit of their multiplication will be equal to multiplication of their limits, multiplication of their limits, and we can prove this result. So proofs are very important in analysis, so we are going to prove this result. Very easy approach we are using here, Cauchy definitions. So if we want to use Cauchy definition, so how we can use? Since limit x tends to a fx is equal to l, then this implies, yeah, we can write for given epsilon greater than 0, for given epsilon dash, I am taking epsilon dash greater than 0, there exist, or we can find delta 1 greater than 0 such that mod fx minus l is less than epsilon dash when 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta 1 and limit x tends to a gx is equal to m, so we can find delta 2 greater than 0 such that mod gx minus m is less than epsilon by 2 dash, or we can take epsilon dash when 0 is less than mod x minus a is less than delta 2, less than delta 2. So here, if these two results both are true, so in our previous results, we have seen that if I take, suppose here is delta 1, here is delta 2, then which part result is true for both cases? So this is the common part. So for common part, what we have to take? We have to take minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. So we are taking, suppose delta is equal to minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. If delta is minimum of delta 1 and delta 2, then what we can write the results? Mod of fx minus l is less than epsilon dash when 0 less than mod x minus a is less than del, and mod gx minus m is less than epsilon dash when 0 less than mod x minus a is less than delta. So these two results hold. Now we have to prove that limit of multiplication of fx and gx is equal to multiplication of their limits. So we have to prove, if I take fx into gx, then this limit of multiplication of these two functions will be equal to L into M, We have to prove that this limit of these multiplication will be Lm, and we are taking fx minus fx into gx minus L into M. We are taking this term, and we will prove that this approaches to zero. If we can prove that this term approaches to zero, then we will get our result. So what we can write, this is equal to, or here I am writing equal to mod of fx into gx minus fx into m, okay. So we have subtracted this term, and if we subtract this term, then I am adding plus fx into m, minus lm, which is equal to mod fx, and gx, minus m, plus m into fx minus l, then what we get, which is less than equal to, mod fx, into mod gx minus m plus mod m into mod fx minus l, since mod fx minus l is less than epsilon dash, mod gx minus m is less than epsilon dash, so using these properties we get this term is less than mod fx, into epsilon dash plus mod m into epsilon dash, okay. And suppose this inequality is number one, now we will find what is mod fx, okay. So mod fx will be, since mod fx can be written as mod fx equal to what, mod l minus mod l plus fx minus l, okay. I have added l and subtracted l, which is less than equal to mod l plus mod fx minus l, but mod fx minus l is less than epsilon dash, so this whole term is less than mod l plus epsilon dash, number 2, okay. Now using 2 in 1, we have, so what is number 2? Number 2 inequality is this, fx into gx minus lm is less than mod fx into epsilon dash plus mod m into epsilon dash. So I am using here value of mod fx. So what we get, mod fx into gx minus lm. So 1 becomes mode fx into gx minus l into m is less than mode fx, which is mode l plus epsilon dash into epsilon dash, or plus mode m into epsilon dash, okay, into epsilon dash plus mode m into epsilon dash. So we have taken this term, which is equal to mode l plus mode m plus epsilon dash into epsilon dash. Okay, we get this term. And this is the condition when 0 is less than mode x minus a is less than delta. So this is the case. So if we choose epsilon dash such that epsilon dash is less than epsilon upon mode L plus mode M plus epsilon dash, then we have, okay, so we can choose epsilon dash in this manner, then what we get? Mode fx into gx minus L into M is less than. So this epsilon dash is less than. So this is mode L plus mode M plus epsilon dash. And epsilon dash is less than this term. So I can write. So this inequality again holds. So epsilon upon mode L plus mode M plus epsilon dash. So this term is cancelled out by this term. And what we get? This implies mode fx into gx minus l into m is less than epsilon when 0 is less than mode x minus a is less than delta. And which is the definition of limit? Hence what we get? Hence we can write limit x tends to a fx into gx is equal to l into. So what we have proved in this theorem, we have proved that if limit of fx when x tends to a is equal to l, limit gx when x tends to a is equal to m, then limit x tends to a fx into gx equal to l into m. Okay, so this is important result, that is multiplication. Limit of multiplication of two functions is equal to multiplication of their limits. तो अभी तक हमने दो results, जहां तक लिमिट्स के एलजेब्रा की बात करें, दो रिजल्ट्स हम अभी तक प्रूव कर चुके हैं. एक तो ये कि लिमिट्स के सम या डिफरेंस, अगर हम देखें फंक्शंस का सम या डिफरेंस है, उसकी लिमिट उसके डिफरेंस लिमिट्स के सम या डिफरेंस के इक्वल होती है, या फंक्शंस के मल्टीप्लिकेशन की लिमिट उनकी लिमिट्स के मल्टीप्लिकेशन के इक्वल होती है. हमारे नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में हम प्रूव करेंगे कि अगर दो फंक्शंस हमें दे रखे हैं, उन फंक्शन के कोसेंट की लिमिट भी अपन किस तरह से लिमिट्स के कोसेंट की फॉर्म में उसको हम लिख पाएंगे, तो ये हम अपने नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में करेंगे. अगर हमारे वीडियोस आपको पसंद आ रहे हैं तो हमारे चैनल को जरूर सब्सक्राइब करें, लाइक करें, शेयर करें, और किसी भी तरह की अगर आपकी क्वेरी है तो कमेंट बॉक्स में डालकर आप हमसे डिस्कस कर सकते हैं. नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स.